Hello, I'm Dr. Deb, and I'm the department chair and instructor for the Learning Strategies Department here at VC. In today's video, I'm explaining Bloom's taxonomy and how students can use the taxonomy to improve their thinking and learning. VC's Total Learning Center presents Dr. Deb Explains Bloom's Taxonomy. Bloom's taxonomy was created in 1956 and updated in 2001. The taxonomy, a classification system, identifies six levels of thinking from the lowest at the bottom to the highest at the top. While it is mainly designed for teachers to ensure that students are thinking at all levels of the taxonomy, it can also be used by students to enhance their thinking and learning and to ensure that they're moving beyond the bottom two levels to the higher levels of critical thinking. In the taxonomy, the lowest level is remembering. This is memorizing or simply recalling information that is known. It may or may not involve any understanding of the concepts or material involved. Let's use the restaurants of Joe's Pasta and Olive Garden as an example. What types of food do these restaurants serve? Where are these restaurants located in Victoria? These are simple knowledge questions that anyone who is familiar with the two restaurants can answer without much thought. The next level is understanding. At this level, comprehension of the topic or concept occurs. One has to know a bit more than the mere facts about a topic, but it's not overly taxing on the brain. For example, again, using the restaurants, questions at this level might focus on items such as, why is Olive Garden decorated the way it is? Or why do these restaurants create the atmospheres that they create? These two levels are the lowest levels of thinking. Unfortunately, this is where many students spend a lot of their time. They memorize facts, dates, and figures, and only comprehend the bare minimum on the topic or concept in order to pass the exam. The third level is applying the information. This is where a lot of students stumble on the exams. Most teachers and employers want students to transfer the information from one course or situation to another. This means that they expect the students to use the information in new ways that have not been practiced in class. As an example of this, many math instructors have their students practice the Pythagorean theorem with right triangles. They give them many examples in homework and practice problems. However, if on the exam the instructor changes the look of the right triangle the least little bit, the students are often lost, angry, and upset because they've never seen that problem before and didn't know it was going to be on the test. In reality, it's just an attempt to see if students can transfer the information from one context to another. If they can't, then they haven't really learned the material. In our restaurant example, applying the information might look something like this. What dishes would you serve if you were to open an Italian restaurant? Or, how would you decorate an Italian restaurant if you had one? The fourth level of Bloom's taxonomy is analyzing. At this level of thinking, you need to be able to break down the parts of a concept or topic in order to see how they relate to one another. One common method is to compare and contrast the two items. In our restaurant example, we would first want to determine the categories for a comparison. Let's choose price, atmosphere, and food quality. Then you would rate each restaurant in each of these areas to see how they are alike and different. As you can see, this takes a bit more thinking, an in-depth understanding of the topic, in order to think at this level. The fifth level of Bloom's taxonomy is evaluating. At this level, you are making a judgment and justifying a decision that is made. For example, which restaurant do you prefer and why? This is hopefully based on some analysis and not just a feeling. So again, one has to have a deeper understanding of the concept. And finally, the last and highest level of thinking is creating. At this level, you are creating something new. So it requires the most thinking and effort on your part. Using our example, this may involve creating a new ad campaign for your chosen restaurant, or creating your own restaurant that's even better than Joe's Pasta or Olive Garden. So how can college students use Bloom's taxonomy to be successful in college? First, for every concept, They must actively try to move beyond remembering and understanding, even if their instructors have not asked them to do so. This means that as they learn, they are thinking about how to apply this information in new situations, how to break down or examine all factors or parts of the concept, how to make judgments and justify the decisions, and how to create your own new ideas and concepts based on what you've learned. That is how Bloom's taxonomy works to ensure that you are developing the critical thinking skills you need and not just operating at the two lowest levels of thinking. Leave a comment below and tell me what you think about this concept and how it can help you learn. If you want to know more about how to be a successful college student based on the theory, strategies, and principles for student success, click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell, and check out my other videos, as Dr. Deb explains.